Hello everyone, today we are going to use COMSOL 5.6 and do a modeling of surface micromachine accelerometer. This model is important for many of the MEMS applications. Now let us start the model by opening a previous model's geometry. It is available in COMSOL website, anyone can download. Even in our case, we are going to load the file. So, open file and choose open. And in the open, wherever you have saved your file, you have to locate your file. We have saved it in a file named surface mic underscore ACC, that is surface micromachine accelerometer. In this, we are having certain files, geometric subsequences, geometric sequences, and the complete accelerometer pre-modeled simulation. Now we will select geometric sequence, because if you open the tutorial of COMSOL, you will find that the geometric sequences that are being drawn upon absorb geometric sequences. So geometric sequences includes geometric subsequences. Instead of building the entire geometry or the geometric sequences, let us take the geometry sequence directly. Now, this model is utilizing two kinds of a phenomenon. One is the electrostatic phenomenon, the other is the structural mechanics phenomenon. So that is actually added as a predefined physics. This is a stationary model. Now we will go into the details of this analysis. So this geometry is pre-built. What we will do first is, we'll click on wire entering. Okay, so, and next we will click on zoom extents. So using these two, we are able to see that the geometry is actually having a certain layer with fingers. Next, what we will be doing is, we'll go into the home toolbar and click add materials. In the built-in, we will choose gear. And we will add to component one. You see here, there's an Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio that are missing. Usually what happens is that for a elastic material only we define Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio, but here as a material in a simulation tool is supposed to behave like an elastic material, so we are expected to input Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio. So if you search on Google dry air Young's modulus, you will be ending up with results such as this. But I have what people normally ask, what is the Young's modulus of air? It is less than 1 but not 0. I would like to choose a value of 0.56 for this purpose. For no specific reason at all. And it seems to lie in the range of 0 and 1, which is perfect for our experiments. In a similar line of reasoning, I came across this website, glossary.ametsoc.org/wiki/Poisson_constant. I think this is the Poisson ratio which I am looking for. And for dry air, it is given that K is equal to 0.2854. But for moist air, there is a K calculation involved. So I would like to use dry air for this purpose. So what we will do is, we'll enter 0.56 for Young's modulus and 0.2854 as the Poisson's ratio. So this is what defines our air. Next, if we look at these values, it is clear that we are required to generate another material. Let us select, in this case, MEMS, semiconductors and polycrystalline silicon. MEMS, semiconductors, polycrystalline silicon, and add to material one. Now, in the home toolbar, let us close this toolbar. And now, in the settings window for material, locate the geometry entity selection. From the selection list, choose polysilicon. And so, what we will be doing is, we will go into definitions, click on explicit. In the settings window for explicit, type here all domains in the label text field. And then locate the input entities section, select the all domains checkbox. Further, under definitions toolbar, click difference. Then in the settings window, type here in the label. Locate the input entities section under the selection to add, click add. Now in the add dialog box, select all domains in the selection to add list. Next, in the settings window for difference, locate the input entities section. Then under the selections to subtract, you will see that you need to add something here to subtract. Select polysilicon in the selections to subtract. In the model builder window, expand the component one. Then definitions. Then moving mesh. In this, you will have to click on deforming domain 1. When you click on deforming domain, in the settings window, locate the domain selection. From the selection list, choose year. Now solid mechanics. In the model builder window under component 1, click solid mechanics. Here, locate the domain selection section. From the selection list, choose polysilicon. Now, in the physics toolbar, click domains and choose body load. In the settings window for body load, locate the forces section. Here, specify the Fe vector as acceleration star solid dot rho star g underscore const. Previously, we did not have solid dot rho. We used to have rho only. But in this simulation, we are going to have solid dot rho. This is a predefined function in COMSOL. Locate the domain selection section. From the selection list, choose polysilicon. Fixed constraint. Go to physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose fixed constraint. In the settings window, locate boundary selection section. In the selection list, choose anchor plane. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose symmetry. In the settings window, locate boundary selection section. From selection list, choose symmetry plane. Symmetry roller. In the model builder window under component 1 definitions moving mesh, click symmetry roller. In the settings window, locate boundary selection section. From the selection list, choose symmetry plane. Electrostatics. In the model builder window under component 1, click electrostatics. Yes. Now, in the physics toolbar, click domains and choose charge conservation. In the settings window, type charge conservation in the levels list. Charge conservation, comma, air. Locate the domain selection and from the selection list choose air. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose ground. Select boundary 45 only. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose terminal. In the settings window for terminal, type sense terminal L. Now, after the sense terminal, we see that from the selection list, choose sense left boundaries. Locate the terminal section from the terminal type, choose voltage. In the V0 text field type, -2.5 millivolt. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose terminal. In the settings window for terminal, type sense terminal R. Locate the boundary selection and from the selection list choose sense right boundaries. Locate the terminal section from the terminal type, choose voltage. For the voltage, type 2.5 millivolt. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose floating potential. In the settings window for floating potential, locate boundary selection. From the selection list, choose proof mass boundaries. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose terminal. In the settings window for terminal, type self-test terminal R. Locate the boundary selection list. From the selection list, choose self-test right boundaries. Now let us first choose self-test terminal L. And then let us go to right. So here this is self-test left boundaries. Okay. And then we will go into changing of terminal type from charge to voltage, and in the voltage let us type V-test L. This parameter has been redefined when we have loaded the geometry. And then go back to physics toolbar, click on boundaries and choose terminal again. And then we will choose this as the self-test terminal R. And again choose self-test right boundaries and change this to voltage. Let us call this as V test R. So this was fairly simple. Then let us go into meshing. In the toolbar, click boundary and choose free triangular. So on the mesh, right click and then will be getting a boundary. So either you can go this way or you can click on okay, you can even click on this mesh and then in the boundary you can choose free triangle. So in the free triangular, what we are going to do is in the settings window, locate boundary selection section, from the selection list choose meshing plane. So then we will click on build all, right? Now so we have come to the free triangular and we have built all. We can see that there is a fine meshing happening in the geometry that is available in the graphics window. Now what we will do is, I just restored this window by clicking on reset desktop in the home tab. Okay, you can also try this. Next, we see that the build has happened properly because this is the meshing plane which we have selected. What we will do is in the mesh toolbar, we will click on swept. And we will right click on swept one and choose distribution. With the distribution in the settings, we locate domain selection and click clear selection. Right. Select domain 3 only. Now we'll locate in the distribution section the number of elements text field type 1. Okay, we'll click on build all. Next, in the model builder window, right click study 1 and choose rename. Just type the name as study one colon normal operations. Then click OK. In the model builder window, expand the study one normal operation node, then click step one stationary. In the settings window for stationary, click to expand the results while solving. Select the plot checkbox. From the update at list, choose steps taken by solver. Click to expand the study extension section. Now we will have an auxiliary sweep checkbox checked in, and we'll add in this case click range. And in the range for the step type 25, stop 50, but minus 58 start. Then click on add. In the study toolbar, click show default solver. In the model builder window, expand solution 1, cell 1 node. In the model builder window, expand the study one normal operation solver configuration solution 1, dependent variable 1. Then click special mesh displacement. Now, in the settings window for field, locate scaling section. Here, in the scale type 1E-7. In the model builder window, click electric potential comp 1B. Now, in the settings window for field, locate the scaling section. From the method list, choose manual. In the scale text type 1E-3. In the model builder window, click floating potential. Then, in the settings window for state, locate the scaling section. Again, from the method list, choose manual. And here in the text field, type 5E-5. In the model builder window, study one normal operation solver configuration solution 1. Stationary solver 1, segregated 1 node. Right click electric potential and choose move down. Then right click electric potential and choose move down. In the study toolbar, click equals compute. So now we are into the study which we have conducted on Kamsal. The result is that we are able to see a graphical view of the contours that are available through different color profiles. Let us go into the details of the following section. That is, we will now conduct study and other things. But first, let us see what all results we are able to analyze. In the model builder window, expand the displacement to solid node and then click surface 1. Here in the settings window for surface, locate the expression section. In the expression text type U. Now, in the displacement solid toolbar, click plot. Now, in the model builder window, expand the electric potential ES node. Then click multi slice 1. In the settings window for multi slice, locate expression section. From the unit list, choose millivolt. Locate the multi-phase, multi-plane data section. Now, from the, find the X-plane subsection. In the planes, text field type 0. Find the Y-plane subsection. In the plane, text field type 0. In the electric potential ES toolbar, click plot. Now, in the home toolbar, click add a plot group. And choose 1D plot group. Right click 1D plot group 4 and choose point graph. Select a point 65 only. In the settings window for point group, locate the y-axis data section. In the expression text field, type U. In the model builder, right click 1D plot group 4 and choose rename. Type displacement versus acceleration. Hit OK. In the settings window for 1D plot group, locate the plot settings section. In the x-axis level checkbox, in the associated text field type acceleration bracket of G. In the displacement versus acceleration toolbar, click plot. In the home toolbar, click add plot group and choose 1D plot group. Now, right click plot group 5, choose global. In the settings window for global, locate y-axis data. In the table, enter the following settings. ES.FP1.V0. *1000. The units is millivolt. Description is raw sense voltage. Click to expand the legend section, clear the show legend checkbox. In the 1D plot group 5 toolbar, click plot. Now, in the model builder window, right click 1D plot group 5 and choose rename. Type sense V versus acceleration. In the home toolbar, click add study. Go to the add study window, find the study subsection. In the select study tree, select general studies stationary. Click on add. In the home toolbar, click add study to choose the add study window and close it. Now in the settings window for stationery, locate the study extension. Select the auxiliary sweep checkbox. Click add. In the table, enter VTEST L, test voltage, comma left side. (2, 0). Click add. And then VTEST R, test voltage right side, and 0, 2. From the run continuation for list, choose no parameter. In the model builder window, right click study 2, choose rename. Study 2, self test. In the study toolbar, click Show Default Solver. In the Model Builder window, expand solution to Solve to node. Click on Dependent Variables node. Expand this and click on Special Mesh Displacement. In the Settings window or field, locate Scaling section. In the Scale Text type 1E-8. In the Model Builder window, click Displacement field. Settings window for field, locate Scaling section, type 1E-8. In the Model Builder, click Electric Potential. In the Settings window for scale, choose method manual. And in the scale type 1. In the model window for floating potential. Choose in the state the method as manual of the scale. And then in the scale type text 0.1. In the study toolbar click compute.